Happy Frugal Friday, friends. Hey, I see some new people watching over the last couple weeks, and I see some OG K-Squad in there. I'm so glad you guys are here. Let's set our financial goals for 2022. By the end of this video, I'm hoping that you can either set your goals for the new year or have a good idea of what you want them to be. Maybe after the video, you can take a little time, sit down and see, what do I really want my 2022 to look like? And what have I got to do to get there? These goals are all about you, but I'm going to just share for an example what my goals were for last year. Did I hit them or did I fail miserably? The first thing I want you to know about me is back when I started my channel, I had become a single mom a couple years prior, and I had no idea how I was gonna navigate through my finances and get by. And so once I got my arms around it a little bit and I started to have some success, that's when I started the channel to share with other people what I was doing in hopes that it might be hopeful for someone else and be effective in someone else's life. Back when I started this channel, there's no way I would have had the three goals I'm about to share with you because I was nowhere close. This has been a long learning process and it takes years and it takes patience. So just know that wherever you are right now, just start wherever you are. We're gonna take little steps forward until we reach our goals. So my first goal for last year was to max out my Roth IRA. Back a few years ago, picture it, Sicily. Oh, Betty White, I love you, miss you already. I know that was Sophia, but it's Golden Girls. I didn't know what a Roth IRA was until I was introduced to Dave Ramsey, where that was the first time I had ever even heard about it. And I didn't start investing in a retirement account until my late 30s, because I didn't understand it at all. There might be some of you listening right now asking, a Roth IRA what? And that's okay. I'm gonna kind of breeze past it right now because that's not what the video is about. That's another time, but I maxed out my Roth IRA. The most you can contribute to a Roth IRA at my age is 6,000. I believe if you're over 50, this year's cap is 7,000. So if you have never opened a Roth IRA, by the way, if you don't know what I'm talking about, please Google it. Look into it a little bit. I feel like even though I started later in life, it's gonna have a huge impact later. There's a quote out there, something like, the best time to invest was 10 or 20 years ago, but the next best time is today. So if you're not invested in a retirement account, I tell everybody, you and everyone that will hear, if I had known this in my teens and 20s, my life would be totally different. And I just want your life to be different, no matter where you're at, wherever you are hearing this, whatever age, invest in your retirement. So long story short, I maxed out my Roth IRA. The first year I had a Roth IRA, I was only able to invest $1,000 because that's all I could scramble to get. And I was super proud of that. Start small. You might not be able to max it out right away, but you can work toward that eventually. Second goal, and this is huge, you guys, and you guys know I'm completely transparent, so I'm just gonna tell you, back when I used to hear other YouTubers say they've accomplished this goal, I was like, must be nice. I try not to come from a judgy place, but I was a little judgy. I was like, oh, so the goal is I wanted to bulk up my emergency fund from my 6 months to 12. Oh, Buns is here. Now remember, I was saving up for a house for years, remember? And when it came crunch time, we were smack in the middle of the pandemic and I decided not to do the large down payment. So just keep that in mind. Remember, I had been saving. So that's where a lot of that comes from. So I just want you to know, like, it wasn't, didn't happen overnight, not even close. This was years of saving. So long story short, I have reached a 12-month emergency fund. I started with 3 months, I built to 6, and now I have 12. With what's going on in the world, I just don't know what's going to happen. And so I just want to be as prepared as possible. So I thought 1 year, if ish goes wrong, like that will make me feel comfortable. So I have been plugging away, plugging away, plugging away, and it hit that goal. The third one was I wanted to make an additional $10,000 in income from the channel. Basically, I wanted to bring in $10,000 additional income beyond my 9-to-5. And because of all of you, I hit that goal and beyond, actually. So I just want to let you know from the bottom of my heart, this is what I want to be doing, you guys. This is what I want to be doing with you guys even more often. But with my 9-to-5 job, and I'm a single mom, and choreography, and just all the stuff I do, this is what I want to be doing. And because of you, I'm able to do this, and I want to grow this to the point where I can do this all the time, full time, with your help. Okay, so let's shift into this year. What are we going to accomplish this year? What am I going to plan to accomplish this year? I want you to know something about me if you don't already know this. I had one dedicated video back this summer that I explained this. It was talking about seasonal spending. My spending habits have a very clear ebb and flow throughout the year, and I'm going to share it with you briefly, the nutshell version, all right? January, no spend. February, March, low spend. In the dead of winter here in Maine, where am I going? What do I need to spend on? Not much. Honestly, I'm low maintenance in the winter. I don't like to go out on weekends much. I don't ski. It's a lower spending quarter. Think about it in quarters. So first quarter of the year, no spend to low spend. So I'm squirreling. I'm squirreling away, people. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm squirreling because summer's coming, okay? So no to low. Second quarter, April, May, June. Meh. Things are starting to lighten and brighten up around here. Maybe I crawl out of my house once in a while. I'm just kidding. But like really, like I spending maybe increases a little bit. And as I explained in the other video, I feel like it's like a bow and arrow. It's like winding up. July, August, September, pow! I spend like crazy. And I expect to, okay? We have a very short season here of wonderful weather. All my Mainers watching this, all my New Englanders, everybody that has cold weather, right? We've got a short season of genius weather, right? So moderate for second quarter. Third quarter, I'm going hard, okay? July, August, September, it's my son's birthday. It's the beach. It's going out to restaurants. It's seafood at my favorite places. It's ice cream. There's all the things, okay? And then there's Christmas. So like October, November, December is kind of back to moderate to high, right? So the first half of the year, you guys see where I'm going with this. Summer, end of the year, Christmas. I don't go insane, but I do spend more than January, February, March. And it's nice to know that this is coming. So, because last summer, you guys were like, I am spending out of control in July. And I'm like, guys, I plan to spend out of control in July, honestly. Like that's how it goes. That's my ebb and flow. But if you plan for it, you budget for it, you can be unapologetic about it because you've planned. Just something to think about. So my goals for 2022, max out the Roth IRA. Again, that's $6,000. I started something new, you guys. I just started this in November and I don't have a clear enough picture for you to tell you go do it yet because I haven't been doing it long enough. But I started an M1 finance account. For those of you that have heard about it and have just been kind of waiting, you're not sure, I'm gonna leave my referral link below. If you sign up and you contribute your first $100, you're gonna get an additional $50. And so will I. So thank you in advance if you use my referral code. I have only contributed $100 in December. Then I got that free $50, so there's $150. And then I put another $100 this January at the first week of the year. So I've only invested $250 yet. It's barely grown $10 yet, but I just started. If you've never invested before, this might be a way to dip your toe in. Again, Google, do some research of your own. I don't want to give any bad advice. I just want to let you know that's what I'm doing. And the goal is to contribute every single month for the year. And I'm trying to do hopefully $100. That's what I'm hoping to do every month. So at the minimum, I will have contributed $1,200. If for some reason I have some extra money, I might throw some more at it. You get to pick the stocks that you're interested in. Again, once I have more time under my belt with that to kind of let you know how it's going, I'll probably talk more about it if it's something I think you should do more of. But for those that have been teetering on it, you already know about it, or you're like, hey, you know what? I want to try it. Check it out. Use my code. Get started. The big goal I have this year is to pay down my mortgage early. That's not going to happen this year. It's not going to happen for many years, but I'm going to attack. And this was like a hard decision for me, guys, because you have your mortgage and then it's like, should I be paying off the mortgage or should I be investing? Now, my interest rate for my mortgage is 3.25. I bought the house in 2020. And yeah, I heard some people got down in the twos for percentages, but I'm pretty happy with the 3.25. So investing versus paying off the house, this is like tale as old as time. Like, what do we want to do here? So I'm going to do a little bit of both. I am putting a percentage of my paycheck into Maine State Retirement. I'm doing the Roth IRA. I'm doing M1 Finance now, and I am going to attack this mortgage. So my plan is, if you guys remember, I was putting $100 a month toward the principal every month in addition to what I'm paying, right? So like, you have your mortgage and on top of that, I'd be putting $100 toward the principal every month. Then just recently, I upped that to $200. So all this year, I'm gonna be paying $200 additionally toward the principal. And whenever I make some additional money or I get a tax refund, I'm gonna always be thinking like, I'm gonna put a part of that toward the principal so I can pay this mortgage down faster so I don't have to pay as much interest over time. And honestly, I could argue either way with like the, oh no, you should invest, oh, you should do the mortgage. I'm gonna do a nice happy medium because that's the way I like to do it. Here are a few ideas when you're thinking about your goals for the year, right? So if you don't have an emergency fund yet, I would highly, highly, highly recommend, suggest, encourage you to start one. Start with 3 months, maybe get to six. If you want to do more, that's totally up to you and your family. But having an emergency fund, your safety net, I talked about this in another video, is such a life changer. Paying off debt. Do you have credit cards, student loans, personal debts? What can you chip away at so that you can take that weight right off your shoulders? Saving for house repairs, car repairs, all of the things like in case these might be something you want to set up. Vacations. Guys, I went on my first vacation last year. If you missed that video, check it out. I really realized that that is something that I want to make some space for in my budget for me and my son, my family, to have some experiences. So that might be something, depending on where you're at, that might be a little later down the road. If you've got huge debt and you've got lots of financial stress, don't plan your vacations right now. But as you pay those off and things start to lighten up, start looking forward to it and planning for it. Retirement. If you have not started any kind of retirements, if you have a 401k at work, get into that. Give that a try. If you can contribute up to what they match, if they offer a match, do it. The other option at certain places will be a 403b. If you can get in on that action, get in there. Roth IRA, M1 Finance, find somewhere to start building up that retirement for later. There are so many other things. There's endless things that you could be saving for. Think about, what do I really want? Not what other people tell you you need. What do you need? What do you want? What would help you sleep at night? What would get you excited about life? Pick your target and let's do this. Now is your turn, K-Squad. Take a second, go into the comments, let us know. What are your financial goals for 2022? I can't wait to go through them and see what everybody is aiming for. If you're new to budgeting, you guys, I want you to always know you can come here for some humor, for some lighthearted encouragement. I love talking about these topics. Budgeting, frugal living, saving money, minimalism. I love all this stuff. I'm energized by it. If you haven't hit subscribe yet and you like talking about this stuff too, hit the red subscribe button. Oh, and by the way, can you guys hit that like button if you like this kind of content? Let's the algorithm know you like this kind of stuff. And it gets my videos to other people that want to talk about it too. Hit the bell so you're notified each time I upload. I am going to leave you a couple useful videos here on this end screen for you to watch next. I'm so glad you're here. I can't wait to read your comments. Let's do this, K-Squad. I will see you next week for the next Frugal Friday video. Bye, guys. Traditionally, I have a really special guest that pops in.